VakifBank Istanbul. Player number 5, Team 2. Number 6, Kura Akman. Number 10, Lonikis Lucius. Number 11, Nas Aile Akio. Number 15, Kimberly Hill. Number 16, Milena Krasic. And libero with the number 1, Hatice Gizem Erge. Head coach, VakifBank Istanbul. Buongiorno, Giovanni Giudetti. Number 4, Nana Iwasaka. Number 6, Yuki Ishii. With the number 9, Maya Takalusna.
Number 15, Ayano Nagore. And Libra, with the number 20, Saya Tsutsu.
Coach,
our business is Miss Kumi
Nakada.
So the first game is set up here. Here we go, Manila. Clap your hands.
Through the gap of the block.
First point goes to VakifBank. Kimberly serving once again, aided by the net. And there's Zhu Ting, flexing her muscles early.
Making it look so easy.
Kimberly serving again. That time, catches the net.
Well, she has been trying to go for that sharp, short serve. She's too low this time.
Move over to the other side. Japan with a serve. Boy, they've been hitting that net quite a lot here early, but quick point once again here for Istanbul. The experts are saying on paper, this should be favor going to Istanbul. They go to the outside once again, and the block is there. Moving it over to the middle. Zhu Ting net.
Yeah, I think Zutin was trying to hit it towards a certain angle.
Three, two. On the outside, Zutin, there's no way you can dig something like that.
Well, Zutin, of course, knowing her caliber, you can't just put one blocker on her and end that last attack. You only had Nagaoka in front of her.
It's 4-2. Back set works for the Japanese.
Better set for the Japanese. It's a quick back set. Nagaoka finding that gap between Zutin and Vasek.
I'm quite surprised here, Denise, that we have Gozde, who is the team captain of VakifBank, warming up still here behind their bench. She has not been fielded in here for the first six. Zutin serving. Crowd favorite. You know, Denise, there was a meet and greet with the Filipino fans a few days ago, and Zutin had the most number of people screaming their heads out for her.
Well, everybody knows her. Again, the Filipinos love volleyball, and whether it's our very own or the players, you know, internationally, we appreciate their talent.
Zutin serving again, her team up by three. Got a powerful serve. She comes up with a good defensive stop. Japan trying to send it over, but what can you do when you've got that wall of defenders there for VakifBank?
The solid defense from VakifBank. I think overall, average height, they're taller than the Japanese, and their timing is on point.
The lead is up to four for Istanbul. Zutin again with a serve.
Goes out.
I spoke to so many fans here in Manila, and they're all just smiling from ear to ear that they have a chance to be able to watch the very best players in the world. These are the world championships. Slutches comes up with that hit.
One blocker in front of her.
You're going to need at least two, possibly three.
I know the Japanese are also known for their defense, so maybe that's a strategy they're trying to go through to just keep that floor defend the floor.
Exactly, but you know, with the quality of Lumeki's slotches, we need to send at least two. Another mistake on turn, that's a third already here for Istanbul. Hisamitsu, though, still down by three. Over set. Here come the Japanese, slowly but surely. The tally's 8-6. Quick play works. No, the Japanese, as you said, their tremendous floor defense working that time. Power tip's not going to work. Back set. Slotches once again. Boy, she was dug there. And that is, I think, what we're going to be able to witness all throughout the week.
Yeah, for sure.
It's 9-6. The coaches will only have twice or two times to be able to talk to their squads through the course of a set. Nice take there by Gizem. Rogers gets to it. From the back row, Zoom.
Something that the Japanese are prepared for, knowing this VakifBank team, you know, every for that kill, and this time she did. Oh, look at that, Iwasaka isn't late for that block.
Lonekis Loches serving. Loneki, also a fan favorite here in the Philippines.
Oh, wow. Very well met. Had nowhere to go that time. Talking about Nana Iwasaka.
The lead of Istanbul has now ballooned to 5. We're going to have a timeout call by Hisamitsu.
So we're going to listen to the music and try to clap our hands with your rhythm. Here we go, my God. Everyone, make some noise.
Very, very powerful, as you can see. Look at that wall.
Well, it was easily red play, I think, for the Japanese.
Let's see if they can vary their attacks right now. They're down by 5. Loneki serving. Quick play, and the outside's red once again. The Japanese have done very well with their floor defense. Just when I said that.
Thank you.
They get caught in the bonfire.
A great job there by Kimberly Hill. Very counter attack. Going for that short tip. Soft tip, rather.
Loneki serving again.
That's their fourth mistake. But, you know, as we've noticed, they have been trying to go for that short ball, even in some of their attacks. Not really for those powerful long ones. Really challenging the defense of the Japanese.
As you said, it looks like it's by design.
Yeah.
From the back row. They just continue to go to slow, just regardless of whether she's in the back.
Well, I'm not surprised.
Kimberly serving again. She started off this match with a few good serves. And when I said that, again, they come up with a service mistake, which is at number 5. But still a very comfortable lead here as we have Yuki serving for Hisamitsu Springs. Zoo
just going over those two blockers.
What a welcome addition, huh? You already have a formidable squad if you bring in somebody who can't beat the Olympics. Fresh off her gold medal stint.
She's the epitome of what you call reinforcement.
I don't think you can get a better reinforcement anywhere in the world. Up the middle. That's not fooling anybody.
You know what, the Japanese, they have been trying to go to those quick plays. I can understand that because it worked in the first part of the first set. But at this point, it's very well read by the VakifBank. What they need to do is really throw it somewhere else, get that momentum going, and try to go back to those quick plays later on.
That time, they look for it down the line, and it works. Take a look at this ultra fast spike presented to you by PLDT Home Ultra Plan 699. Ang pinakaabot kaing internet na pampamilya. Back set, Doug. That sprayed long. They say it is off
the touch. Yeah.
Tips. You do have a challenge system here just in case. The coaches want to do that, but obviously, VakifBank says yes, he went off one of our players. A kept alive, but sent wide. Hisamitsu here with a little rally. Japanese have been really good defensively. That one though was just impossible to return.
You know, every single time she goes up for an attack, I automatically think in my head it's going to be a point for VakifBank.
And why can't you think that way? Obviously with the way that she's been playing here and what she's shown all throughout the Rio Olympics. Good serve. The Japanese once again trying to go on the outside. As Denise said, that might be the better alternative. Look at the defense here of Istanbul. Slotches!
Smart move, Slotches, going up against a smaller blocker from Japan, I think. That was against Shinabe.
Control the fast break presented to you by PLDT Homo Zeta Plan 699. Ang pinakabot kayong internet na pampamilya. The lead back up to six. Just when it looked like Japan was making some headway, that's going to help though.
That's what Japan is trying to go through right now. They're trying to do Iwasaka hitting it off the blocker's hands. Not really trying to go for the court.
More consistent on their serves. Look at that, they were just trying to tip it over. But the defense was number one, not just there, but they were much taller, and they sent it back quickly.
Yeah, and they've got the hops too, talking about VakifBank. So if you're not gonna go for, you know, a hard hit, maybe go for a quick one.
Zhu Ting. Miscommunication there by the Japanese, and that cannot work. You've got to be picture perfect if you want to be able to have a good attack against VakifBank. Another nice serve right there by Zhu. Kimberly all by her lonesome, and that's all they needed.
No, I think that was actually a better play for the Japanese. Having one blocker in front of Hartska. But just the timing on that block.
Watch it there once again. All by her lonesome. Picks up the point, picks up the block. As Japan calls another timeout. Is our tally. Japan down by eight and out of timeouts. Poor reception ace here for Zhu. Right now, Denise, you can see Istanbul just breezing through this first set.
Well, they have been doing a lot of good things so far. Well, aside from their services, they've had five service errors.
They've had five service errors and they're
still
up this big.
Yeah.
Here comes the captain. I guess they're trying to ease her into the competition, knowing that maybe they feel maybe not the strongest six. They can still take on Japan and right now, it's obviously showing.
Well, the games are played every day, so if you can keep some of your best players in the best condition, of course, that is the first thing in mind for the coaching staff.
Risa Shinabe serving now for Japan. See if they can build up some momentum to get closer, or at least get some momentum moving on to the second set. Quick play doesn't work.
Good defense from Tukarska. And they need a lot more of those if they want to catch up, or at least get that momentum going into the second set later.
Excellent serve. Not the best of passes. Slotches tries to adjust. Sends it long though.
It was obviously going to go out. She was kind of under the ball.
Lead has been cut down to six. This is the rally the Japanese were looking for. Shinabe serving again. Well, now we're going to have our first challenge using the Hawkeye system. And the challenge is there was no touch. Or there was a touch, rather, because the point did go to Hisamitsu. Well, you said it a while ago because she was really under the ball already.
Yeah.
So the chances of that ball coming down. So the point stands. And VakifBank's Giovanni loses a challenge. Bang! Slotcha says, I missed the other one. I'm not missing this time.
She has been very consistent on that opposite side. Again, going up against a blocker, our shorter blocker from the Japanese.
Ace there for Milena. Rasic has played so well here today. That's a much better pass for the Japanese. They go on the outside, but still, again, Snotches was there.
At this point, you can just really say Hides might. I mean, that's all it is.
The Japanese have been varying their attacks here,
but
at the same time, the defense just happens to know what they're going to be doing.
And their floor has been steady as well.
Free play. Quick play works. They're really just going just about anyone talking about VakifBank, and it's been working.
Yeah, the thing is, the center has been distributing their ball very well. So the Japanese, even though they have a strong floor defense, they're still kind of adjusting to it. There has been a half second delays, and I think it's really about the blocking. Also, they need to have a better net defense if they want to bounce back in the second set.
Kubra picked up that last point. First set goes to Istanbul with a score of 25-15.
The first set in the first game is over.
Let's take a look at some of the action here of set number one. That was aptly taken by VakifBank Istanbul.
You know, Japan gave a good fight, especially in the first part of that first set. Nagaoka was trying to attack on her own. Floor defense was there, but it was just too much power from VakifBank, of course, led by Zhu Ting from the reinforcement from China. You also have Loneki, Rasik, and everybody else was just attacking. Even though they had a lot of service errors, they made up for it definitely in their blocking department.
With five service errors, they still took that first set so handily.
By 10.
So it makes you think if they were a little bit more perfect as far as the serves were concerned, that first set could have ended even earlier.
Yeah.
Hisamitsu Springs, Kobe has come up with a decent game. They've had their import. Tokarska, that's Maya Tokarska, trying her very best, but she's the only one that they have blocking up front.
Well, the thing is, she's the when she's in front, she has two shorter blockers beside her. So I think that's also one reason why they're trying to use just the one block system and then just be more steady on the floor. But at the same time, they have to change something because it's, I think it's evident that it's not really working as well as they wanted to. They were down by 10 points in that first set, and if they're not going to change their blocking system, then maybe just double their efforts on the floor, which I don't even know how they could do that because they've been doing so well.
And the balls are just coming too steeply angled for them to really be able to do anything on the floor. And very quickly you see here, VakifBank gets the first point. Kimberly Hill serving. Another one of those fan favorites. Back set. That gets through. One of the few times they've got past that wall.
Was a quicker set for the Japanese, and the walker from back was late.
We're tied at one. Well, it has not been a problem for the Japanese to stay in step early, but then all of a sudden, from the middle stage up until the very end, they get left behind.
Well, just like that attack from Zhu Ting, I mean, how are you going to stop that? When you have two blockers, even three in front of you or in front of an attacker, but she goes over those blockers, that's really going to be hard.
Right now, the Japanese have nobody that can really block any of the attackers from VakifBank because Tokarska is just making her entrance right now. So she sat out the first couple of points. Now comes in for the libero, Tsutsui. And let's see if she can help out in the front. Back set, they go to the outside. Nakaoka gets denied again.
Nakaoka. Like that directly to the hands of Zhu Ting. As you can see here, even Rasik was on time for that block.
They're just so tall. The moment it comes off that block, it goes straight down to the floor and it's a point. And go to the outside. That one works with a down-the-line attack.
That's where they get most of their points when they go for those quick, long attacks. Or sets, rather. Because it's going to be hard for the middle blocker to catch up. But that time, Japanese goes straight, and Naz really wasn't that ready for it.
She got surprised that was coming her way. Nice serve there from Nagaoka. Look at all the spin. Slot just gets denied.
Better defense now for Tokarska.
That brought a lot of the Japanese players right here beside us on their feet. we can block as well. Hisamitsu now up by one. Another excellent serve from Nagaoka. Chance once again here for Japan. Can they get some offense? Question is, can they get it past that wall? So far, the answer has been no. Quick play! How do you stop that, Denise?
I know. We have been, before that play, we saw a lot of great saves from the Japanese. But again, if there's a quick attack from VakifBank and you only have one blocker in front of her, I mean, there's so much space where she can put that ball.
Well, it's a fast break presented to you by PLDT Home Altera Plan 699, ang pinakaabot kayang internet na pampamilya.
Service saves from Zoo.
Slowly but surely, VakifBank now has the lead, and they're trying to pull away.
Nice.
Well, one of the few times they've gone through that kind of attack, and it works.
Yeah, good decision there by the setter, attacking on her own, having the initiative to do that.
Cunning play. More and more people are coming inside the Mall of Asia Arena. This is day one of the competitions. Club World Championships, and another point here for VakifBank and Loneki Slotches. Watch this ultra fast break presented to you by PLDT Home Altera Plan 699. Ang pinakaabot kayang internet na pampamilya. Lead is still at one. Not a good pass. Ishii just sends it over. Kimberly Hill delivers.
So it's really hard for the Japanese, especially if those kinds of attacks happen, because, you know, you're not, of course, going to defend at the end of the court. But when the ball hits the blockers and it bounces off like that, it's going to be hard for them to really run after the ball.
7-5 is our tally. Denise. Denise, those are the mistakes the Japanese cannot afford. Not at this stage.
Oh, yeah. I think they're trying to catch up. They're down by a set, down by 3 points. If you want to get your momentum, you got to be focused all the time.
They're going to keep this one alive. But it's a free ball once again for Istanbul. They go to the outside.
That was a very good time to set from VakifBank. The timing was based on the quicker, and look at that. Kokarska fooled by the quicker of VakifBank.
He was caught in no man's land. The lead is now 4. Istanbul now.
Oh.
Trying to make their move.
Too high miscommunication between Nakaoji and Nagaoka.
Hisamitsu Springs will talk things over. Istanbul now in control of the second set. We mentioned that earlier. The fact that the Japanese can stay in step, but only very early in the set.
Well, the thing is, it's like they've been reading VakifBank at the early part of the set, but afterwards, when VakifBank gets all fired up, when they get their momentum, it's really going to be hard for the Japanese, or it has been hard for the Japanese to catch up.
The Japanese need more of those attacks. Okarska serving. Karska sends that up, and it's a free ball here for Istanbul. They go to the back set. Slotches thought that was a 1 point. Now the Japanese coming up with some good blocks. Again, just trying to send it over, Denise. You can't even get it over that lady.
She basically handed it to Akman.
She was standing right there, and she said, thank you very much. That was an early Christmas gift. 25-year-old Loneki Slotches.
Nice.
Combination play, one of the few times they tried to do that. Japanese able to get blocked to every now and then. Watch it there. They knew exactly what Hill wanted. Free ball coming up. Nope. They ran out of real estate. Nadal and company need to come up with a much more solid showing. They want to stay in step. Here's another one of the stars, Kimberly Hill. Doesn't get it over. But overall, they've been serving much better. Tell me about back-to-back.
Yeah, I think percent. They weren't even at 20, and they had 5 already. And at my count, they only have 2 right now.
Zoo
again, just going over Nagaoka and Iwasaka. You know, it's so hard because, you know, the whole defense system is based on your blockers. So if your attacker goes over that, then it's just like not putting a blocker in front of her.
So then what do you do? That was the question I was going to pose to you. What's going through the mind of Coach Takada right now? She's on the bench shaking her head saying, my defense was there, but they're just going over it.
Yeah.
Lead is now at 6. On the outside, Shinabe is dug. Zoo sends it over.
You can't do that.
How many times have they tried to go over Milena?
I think that this is like the third, fourth time.
That was supposed to be a free ball.
Look at this. Skipping it on the hands. Towards the hands of those two.
If Nagaoka's not going to hit that with power, you got to send it over, but send it high.
Yeah.
And then pray. I think at this stage, prayer might not even be enough.
Tremendous blocking. Back and back. And I always say this, and everybody can agree, that defense will always be our number one offense. And this time, their offense is their offense, but their defense is their offense. So it's just...
What can they do? Let's see. As they talk things over. The Japanese shaking their heads, looking to the heavens, saying, what can we do?
Well, that is the question. This is the start of the match. VakifBank is doing very well on the blocking department, knowing who to block, knowing their timing.
I guess they're saying we need to clone Tokarska and have at least two more of her. And that still might not be enough.
Well, but at that last play, Shinabe was actually able to get it through, finding the gap at the clock.
Well, I think you hit it right on the head. I mean, the timing has got to be exquisite.
Yes.
As far as their attack is concerned, if they want to be competitive.
I think that's their best option. Try to go for those quick, long sets. Just to delay the middle blocker.
But the question is, what do they do when you come up with an offense like Zoo? Well, they had an answer that time.
Shinabe going down the line this time. It's so seldom that they go for that straight attack. And VakifBank not expecting it.
Ultra Fast Break presented to you by PLDT Home Hotel Plan 699, na pinakaabot kaing internet na pampamilya. The lead has been cut down to six. Not a good pass from Kimberly. It gets Uzu. Do they go back to Zoo? No. They go to the middle. Kimberly Hill stuck. My goodness. The defense is not getting recovered, and Milena is already attacking.
You know the thing, when we're at this level, you can't have those over reception. Because that's the thing that's going to happen. For sure.
You'll get killed. Lead back up to seven. Naz serving. That went through the block. Well, that is not the specialty of the libero and Gazem. So you can give her that mistake.
And she has been doing well also.
Actually, both liberos have been doing excellent here. Nice serve from Nagaoka. Look at all that spin.
Okay.
Sent to the back. Back set once again. Zoo is dug. Back row attack doesn't work. Wow, that was a relentless attack from the Japanese, but nothing worked.
You know, the thing is, they have been trying to go for those quick attacks, but it was their defense, actually, that was struggling to get back on the right defense formation because the libero has been trying to go for those saves. So it was VakifBank who was actually steady at the net.
Tutui did her job, but the offense wasn't able to help her out. Talking about the Japanese squad. Hisamitsu out of timeouts. Down by six. They'll need to string some points together. Ball coming up once again. Shinabe just sends it over. Naz goes to the outside and Kimberly delivers.
And Kimberly taking advantage of the fact that she only had one blocker in front of her. That was Nakaoji trying to go for that block.
Serve. Tutui gets to it.
No coverage.
Well, Tutui had to come all the way out here to be able to help just get that back into play. Milena serving once again. VakifBank 5 points away from taking set number two. Tutui was there trying to get support, but the ball was just a little bit off.
ball just coming back too fast. The coverage was there for the Japanese.
Milena serving again. That set long. No, they're going to say there's a touch, though.
Yeah, I think that was the intention, actually.
Tokarska with a serve. One of the few mistakes we've seen reception-wise. Apologizing was the team captain, Gosden. Tokarska gets an ace. Looking for another one here. Trying to keep her team close. That went back. So many times, Loches, whenever she comes with the attack, she thinks it's always a 1 point. That time it came back once again, and she was out of position.
Well, if you're as good a player as her.
Here's Tokarska. You can see now, taking a little bit of a breather. And with her on the bench, it makes you wonder. She's going to be coming up with a block. She's going to have to wait for a few more points before she's able to come in for the libero here.
Well, let's see. This might be a strategy for Coach Nakada to try to let her rest before coming or going to the third set.
Nagaoka. Boy. Stretch there by the libero.
Good decision by Nagaoka.
You see Kazem, just a fraction of a second late there, but again, you and I were talking about the excellent job both liberos have been doing.
Well, you know, it's very deceiving, her approach. It really looked like she was going for a powerful attack.
Naz goes to Slotches from the back row. And that brings us to set point. Take a look at this ultra-fast bike presented to you by PLD2 Home Data Plan 699. Ang pinakaabot kayang internet na pampamilya. Istanbul looking to make quick work once again in the second set of their Japanese counterparts. Ishii gets denied time and time again. Hardly breaking a sweat here are the ladies from Istanbul.
So it goes back to what they did right in the first set. It was all about their defense, really. I know it's very impressive when we talk about their offense, but it's just fitting that they ended that with a block.
Second set goes to Istanbul once again with a score of 25-15. Let's take a look at some of the action in another dominating and overpowering performance by the girls from Istanbul.
Well, again, it was a convincing win in that second set. Oh, we saw Kimberly Hill, we saw Lineki, we saw Zhu Ting. Everyone actually from VakifBank contributed in their offense, but really it was their defense that spelled out the difference. Not just in set number two, but also set number one. And although the Japanese was trying to put up a fight, with their defense as well. It was just too much power and too much speed for VakifBank.
So they essentially followed the same script as what happened in set number one.
Well, if it's working, you don't have to change anything. And I think they improved because they committed less service errors. Back in the first set, they had five, and here in the second set, they had like a maximum of three.
This is the first of the four games we have here to open day number one of our competition for the Women's Club World Championships for 2016. Doing the honors is Hisamitsu Springs Kobe and VakifBank Istanbul. So far, so good for VakifBank as they've easily won the first two sets. That's the way you want to be able to start out your campaign, with an easy victory, and you show everybody that we're one of the teams to beat.
Yes. Of course, not just in terms of confidence, but also you want that momentum. This is, of course, just a single round. And each and every game, you want to finish it well so that when you actually get to that final round, you know that you're doing good. You know that you don't really have to change much in your system.
And more than anything else, you need to come up with the wins early because you need to be able to finish in the top two to be able to move on to the next phase of competition. Block once again there. Just like in the second set, the Japanese take the first point.
Yeah, and always starting really well.
And then they hit the wall. And it's all downhill. We're just making light of the situation, but you know, the Japanese have been trying their very best, but they're just being outgunned.
And you can see it, like with their coverage, they're really trying to keep that ball alive, trying to go for those dives. But sometimes, really, the height of this VakifBank team is just overpowering.
It is 2-0. Sent long. The Japanese cannot afford to do that. Now they're building some sort of momentum, leading to nothing, and then all of a sudden they come up with another gift. First point for VakifBank. It's kept alive. 2-2, he sets it up. Here come the Japanese.
Shinabe has been targeting that right hand of the blocker at the opposite side, really trying to go for the touch.
The Japanese star Nagaoka. You see all that tops with that ball, just after it passes the net, just goes straight down. Watch it here once again. This is a joy to watch. And when I say that, she comes up with, you know what, she's had about, I think, 6 or 7 excellent serves. And after I praise her, she comes up with a horrible one.
Well, of course, it is kind of tiring to go back again and again to that service line.
They send it over. Naz goes to Zoo. And Slotches was there just waiting for it.
It was a good save, good dig from the Japanese, but Slotches is ready.
VakifBank down by one. Play by Gazem. Kimberly. Kimberly has been racking up the points here. Nahoji there with a nice smile, but she and her teammates need to be able to come up with a little bit more just to stay competitive. sent that over. Kimberly from the back row. Look at the trajectory of the attack. Yeah, she's on your screens. Kimberly has been part of their one to attack together with Slotches.
That goes out. Well, that's been the plan by Shinabe. Every time she goes for the hit, she's been trying to just hit it off the blockers.
That time, Milena Rasic was very, very disappointed because she got there, just not able to turn it in. They go to the middle. It goes long.
I know, that could have been a good, good point for the Japanese.
But I see you nodding because you like that attack.
I do.
Suddenly, they're trying to vary it once again.
Yes. And it's very seldom that we see a back attack from the Japanese. Normally, if they get that good or that easy ball from VakifBank, they go for a quick set. And goes out.
Zhu with that mistake. We're tied at six.
Knowing that the defense in VakifBank wasn't ready for it, seeing the ball was at the right height. Look at that, no defenders at the back. Zhu Tin caught standing.
Ultra Fast Pike presented to you by PLDT Home Ultra, Plan 699. Ang pinakaabot kang internet na pampamilya. Kimberly. Well, the Japanese are really competitive here in the third. They've woken up.
Yeah, but again, that's what they've been doing, just trying to hit it off the hands of the blockers, trying to turn their hands towards that antenna, or that flick of the wrist is towards the antenna. That has been the strategy right now.
Tokarka serving again. Slotcha sends it over. Tokarka sets it up. Nagaoka dug. Kimberly dug as well. Ishii denied. They go to Nagaoka. What action we're seeing here. Slotches.
Oh, nice. Very well played by VakifBank. You know, that last set, even though everybody was scrambling on their side, setter Naz had a presence of mind to give it back to the opposite side. And look at the blockers of the Japanese. Late middle blocker was late for that last attack, and it goes in.
Ultra Fast Break presented to you by PLDT Home Ultra Plan 699. Ang pinakaabot kaing internet na pampamilya. The Japanese have been very impressive here in the third set. Ishii dug by Zhu. Back to Ishii.
You know, the Japanese have really learned to control their attacks. Every time they're hitting from that opposite out, that open side, that left side, they've been trying to get that ball to hit the antenna or just go out. And when the blockers are standing right in front of them, they're not forcing their attacks anymore so that they could get their coverage.
Nagaoka!
Good touch.
Coach Giovanni's now shaking his head. He might have to use one of his two timeouts. He has never found his team down by three. The Japanese have been able to really adjust. And Kimberly with the adjustment in the air there.
You know, it's always that last second look at the defense of your opponent, and Kimberly seeing, you know, one defender trying to run towards the net.
Neki Slotches, good serve. They try to go to their stars. Ishii denied. Naz has also been working overtime, not just coming up with great sets, but She's also been helping out with the blocks.
Well, she has to, of course. There's three rotations that she's gonna have to be there.
Slotches again.
That's gonna go out.
And you can see the moment it left her hand, it was gonna be long. The lead is back up to two for the Japanese. Ishii now serving. Slotches.
Finds the line.
One against Slotches.
You saw Nakaoji on your screens a while ago, calling out the play. Kimberly, great serve.
Oh, wow.
Well, Zhu Ting lost track of the ball there just for a fraction of a second.
But, you know, great effort. My wow was actually for Zhu Ting because I thought that was going to be a good block once again. But great effort also from the Japanese side.
Nagaoka says, I got you.
Yeah. But a blocking from Pekarska also.
Zhu!
Zhu Ting, so she didn't get that block. The last attack, now she gets it through Nagaoka and Pekarska easily.
I think she was just so disappointed about what happened in the previous point. She let it all out in that one. Ultra Fast Break presented to you by PLD2 Home Ultra Plan 699. Ang pinakaabot kayang internet na pampamilya.
Nice.
Cross court works.
And again, that was a quicker set to Shinabe.
Kubra wasn't able to make the adjustment.
Yeah.
And the lead is back up to two here for Hisamitsu Springs. To the outside. Boy, when Zhu just winds up, it's a joy to watch.
It's a joy to watch that blocking as well from VakifBank.
Istanbul with a serve. Go ahead.
It's really the thing that has, you know, given them the lead since the start of the match.
Nice serve from Naz.
Miscommunication with the set, I think. Pekarska was too early for that slide.
Zhu there all by her lonesome. And sometimes, she's enough. In the back row, Kasem gets to it.
Good save.
Nice effort there by Kimberly as well. From the back row.
Wow.
Chance once again for the Japanese to attack. They go to the outside.
Great job by Shinabe. Again, going for that straight hit, knowing the defense of VakifBank was concentrated for the cross court. We can see it here again. Defender was waiting for that short ball.
Fourteen-13 is our tally. Slotches. Doug. Ishii back in front.
Ishii just targeting the hand of... that was... Rasic.
The lead is back up to two. Bang! It can't get any simpler than that, Denise.
She set the ball, she goes up, it's a point.
Zhu Ting, though, in the back row, but you know what? For somebody of the caliber of Zhu, despite the fact that you're serving, you're in the back row, she still comes up with great attacks.
Yeah, she's still an attacker. I mean, you don't lose an option.
That's sent long.
No wrist action there from Kimberly.
Well, Kimberly, the moment she hit it, She turned around and looked at her coach. Giovanni says, it was touched, it was touched. So now we're going to go to a challenge. We're going to be using once again our Hawkeye system, one of the new innovations that we're introducing to you here. The Hawkeye system is actually the system that they use for a lot of the tournaments, like Wimbledon and tennis, and it didn't look like it was touched.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Coach Giovanni looking at Kimberly says, I thought you were right in front. I thought you saw that. No touch, so Coach Giovanni Udete loses a challenge. And the two-point lead of Hisamitsu stays. That's a poor serve from Tokarska. It's a critical stage of the set.
It is, of course. Most especially since the Japanese hasn't been this head-to-head with VakifBank. And first two sets, well, they really can't throw away points.
Milena Rasic serving and tit for tat.
Lucky break there for Hisamitsu.
One of the very few times that it looks like Coach Giovanni is under pressure. Not a good pass. Kimberly makes the adjustment though. Back to Kimberly. The lead is back down to one.
Really, that I mean, those small adjustments made by that time, that was Naz, the setter, giving Kimberly a quicker set.
Lonecki slotches.
Good serve. And it's an ace.
And that ace is going to tie things up at 17. That looked like it was going to graze the net, Denise.
Well, that's how they've been serving, actually, since the start of the match. They've been risking that.
Timeout is going to be called by Hisamitsu. Springs Kobe. This ultra-fan family of the game is presented to you by PLDT Home Altera Plan 699. Ang pinakaabot ka ang internet na pampamilya. That is a great-looking family there. We are tied at 17. Match number one of the Women's Club World Championships for 2016. Coming to you live from the SM All of Asia Arena. The Japanese now. Staying in step.
Great defense.
Nice, just sent that over. Good dig from Zhu. Ishii sends it over, gets the point.
Ishii, smart move. The ball was too near the net. The two blockers was right in front of her. Really just looking at the defense once again. Kimberly caught standing and late for that soft tip from Ishii.
The Japanese clinging on to a one-point edge, and now that one-point edge has just been erased.
That man with that slide. Going down the line, no defender once again for Hisamitsu.
Ackman has been very quiet here, but obviously, you know, the one making the most noise has been Kimberly and Slotches. Well, back-to-back points. Kubra Ackman coming up big in tight situations. Kimberly Hill serving again.
Great.
That gets through.
And you know, I even said great even before that point was called, or that point was made, because I knew that, you know, the middle blocker was going to be late. Ackman was going to be late for that attack.
But from our vantage point, you saw that gap, and the Japanese took advantage of it.
And again, that's the kind of play that has been working for the Japanese since the start of the first set.
Ishibashi serving. The Japanese need a good one, and they got it. Back set, and that's just sent down. That's 3 points in succession almost for Ackman.
Ackman going over the blocker. No problem for her. A lot of space as well. Having just one blocker in front of her, only having Shinabe.
It's also Fast Pike presented to you by BLDT Home Hotel, Plan 699, at pinakaabot kaing internet na pampamilya. It's winning time. This is the business end of the third set. That sent long. The Japanese asking for a touch. Will there be a challenge? No challenge here from Coach Nakada.
Oh, they will challenge.
Oh, yes, they will. Finally, I guess she heard us.
Well, this could be the turning point of the match. So that challenge is really needed here. Oh!
Oh, there was a touch. There, it came off the finger.
Touched the finger of Zhu Ting. Coach Nakada has a very good eye seeing that touch.
So we are tied at 20. This will be very nice to see VakifBank now being challenged.
Yeah, because they've never been in this situation since the start of the match. They've always been up 7, 8, 9 points at a time, closing the first two sets with a 10-point deficit. And now they're down by one.
Tokarska there on your screens. And some of the action. There's the setter. Well, the players have been giving it their all. Lunecki slotches there. Let's see how VakifBank plays under pressure. Serve coming up from Hisamitsu Springs. It's Koto. Good serve. Gets to Zhu. Quick play. Read by the Japanese. Naz goes to Zhu. She's dug. Boy, she can't score in the offense. Score defensively.
Yeah. And this is the advantage of VakifBank, because, you know, the Japanese has been doubling their efforts on their floor defense, even getting that dig from Zhu Ting. But when you have your blocking department on point.
And it has been on point most of the match.
This time, the Japanese blockers.
Another player who's been on point has been Naz.
Oh yeah, so knowing when, where to set that ball, knowing the right speed, the right height.
Hisamitsu Springs will call their final timeout of the third set, might be their final timeout of their first match. Thank you. We'd like to welcome all of you back here to the Mall of Asia Arena for day number one of the FIVB Women's Club World Championships. Naz on your screen serving once again. She has done an excellent job setting for Istanbul. But the Japanese have really come to play here in the third set, and we're tied at 22 each.
The Japanese, you can't really say anything bad about their offense. It's just really that, you know, the blocking department of VakifBank is on point. But this time, Japanese finding the block or the gap there.
Back set, Zhu Ting. She's dug. You know, Denise, the Japanese have been able to make in-game adjustments to the attack of Zhu. In the first two sets, they didn't seem to know how they could return it. Right now, they've been coming up with a lot of excellent digs.
They have. So you have to commend also their core defense. It's really just that offense, when there's two blockers or back-and-back players in front of them, that's where they're having much more trouble.
The Rio Olympics MVP, Zhu Ting with the serve. Quick play works, Pokaska delivers.
Pokaska, very smart, getting that ball back to zone one, knowing that Zhu Ting was supposed to be the one to defend that. And Zhu Ting, as we all know, just came off a serve.
We're tied at 23 apiece. Pokaska now serving. Bang! Kimberly delivers. They know Tokarska serving. She's not going to be able to help with the block. Now we take advantage.
And obviously, they go cross court because, again, looking at the defense there, Iwasaka wasn't able to catch up.
It is now set point, match point for VakifBank Istanbul. Milena, good serve. Chance here for Istanbul to end it. Slotches, dug. Trying to go down the line, it works. And the Japanese are alive.
This is going to be an extended set. Really a much better performance from the Japanese.
They need their star, Nagaoka, as he checks back in. Critical serves coming up. Nice serve from Nakauchi. Slotches denied!
What a time to be on point with her blocking. That time, Iwasaka. Good timing, good read, knowing that Lenecki was going to go for that attack. They might be able to close this one out.
The new confidence here for the Japanese, as they have their first set point of the match. The first two sets were not close.
Yeah, 10-point deficit each.
Big serve coming up here from Nakauchi. All eyes are on her at this stage. Everybody now wondering, where is Naz going to go to? And cross court once again. Floor defense for the Japanese working. Excellent play here. Oh, wow. The floor defense has been exceptional. But then that attack goes awry.
Over set.
We're tied at 25. Slotches serving. Boy, the crowd here on their feet. Coach Giovanni shaking his head. I think he wanted to make a substitution. Lonecki, good serve.
Good play. Again, just deceiving the blockers off Hisamitsu.
Ackman has been one of the more vocal and instrumental players here in the third set.
You know, obviously I can't understand her, but it seems like she's really asking for that ball, always, you know, telling Naz she's ready for it.
Set point, match point number two for Istanbul. Poor serve there from Lonecki.
You know, those things, they could do that in the first set. The first set they had five service errors, but they all committed that probably before the 20-point mark, but here you can't afford to do it.
Ishii, good serve. Naz having to recover. Chance now for the Japanese. They ran out of space though.
Trying to avoid the blockers and back in back. That's why they went cross court, but too much twisting. Zooting comes in.
And the captain takes a back seat. Kimberly Hill with a serve. Third match point for Istanbul.
Oh.
That hit the antenna. And we are tied at 27. The Japanese holding tough.
Great serve.
Got sent over by Naz.
Again, Zooting was there.
That's why you bring her off the bench.
Yeah.
Match point number four, Denise. Will this be the charm? Zoo gets into it. Back set. Slotches gets denied.
Wow. You know, really, it's all about the defense. And Chizuru Koto knowing how to stop that VakifBank attack.
The blocking of Japan has been excellent here in the third. Nice serve from Nagaoka. Zoo goes cross court. She's done.
Challenge that. It looked like there was a touch.
It did look like there was a touch. I agree with you. They do have a challenge. This is going to be critical for the Japanese.
Oh, yeah. Clutch on Milena and her left thumb.
It's now Hisamitsu with set point. Another good serve from Nagaoka. Zoo! Boy, you see how high she went up for that
yeah,
one.
Yeah, I'm not surprised at all. When you get an easy, when you want that easy point, automatic point, you go to Zuting. Zuting even having Nakaoji and Tokarska in front of her.
Serve from the setter, Naz. They go to the outside.
Great attack by Shinabe once again. That's what she's been doing since the start of the second set, actually. Trying to go for those powerful attacks. And the goal is just to just hit it off the blockers.
It's set point once again. Quick play.
That goes out. And Hisamitsu finally gets a set.
Excellent showing here by the Japanese. Just when it looked like the first and second sets weren't competitive,
yes,
they come up with a fantastic third.
Well, they have adjusted very, very well with their defense, not just the floor, but also their net defense, also variating their place. Looking better, definitely, here in the third. And ending the third set with a score of 31-29, yeah.
Let's take a look at what transpired there in the third set. What a transformation here by the Japanese.
Well, again, better performance from them. Nakaoji able to variate her place, giving it to Shinabe, letting Tokarska hit, going back to Nagaoka, and better blocking from the Japanese as well. And even though players like Lineki was able to get it through, I think the Japanese, again, just knew how to play back in the third set. Again, knowing how to use their disadvantages. There were taller players from the side of VakifBank, but that last set, I could see them just really using the blocker's hands and getting points off of them, not really forcing it to go down and hit the floor. And when you see here, aces, almost the same attacks going to Hisamitsu's side. Errors and blocks. The blocks actually still on VakifBank Istanbul side, but at the same time, I think it was the offense of Hisamitsu that really worked. Again, those attacks, most especially by Shinabe, is what I noticed, that she was just using the hands of the blockers.
You know, having said that, obviously that's what the Japanese really need to be able to do, because they don't have the height, they don't have the leaping ability that their counterparts have. But on the other side of the coin, we've not seen VakifBank go to that kind of an approach. They've just been trying to send that ball down every single time. Wherein, you know, that last instance we saw with Slotches, if she went high hands, they might have been able to get the point as well.
Well, you know, it's probably just because in the in their mindset, it has been working for the past two sets. Worked all throughout, just not in the last part, very last part of that third set.
Fourth set is underway, and the Japanese continue where they left off.
Great play. Every time they have those quick ones, quick sets, Shinabe is able to get it through the gap. As you can see here, there's going to be a big block, or big gap between Naz and Ackman.
Ishii Good serve. Well, the Japanese have really tightened things up as far as their floor defense is concerned. There, once again, avoiding the block, makes contact, and it's a point for the Japanese. Do nothing. She's serving again. That stops their momentum.
Yeah, they have to be careful.
It's 2-1 here for Hisamitsu.
I guess we go back to that familiar attack where the Japanese are just using the hands of the VakifBank blockers to get the point. Iwasaka goes back to the line. Oh, wow. No, it's very deceiving, that last attack from Zhu Ting, because her body was actually facing zone 5 already. You would think she would go cross court, but the last second twists her wrist, goes down the line.
Hisamitsu up by one. Nice serve there. Nagaoka. Zhu Ting, it really been able to make the adjustment as far as her attacks are concerned.
Well, if you're the number one player in the world, you should be able to do that. Oh, wow, good block. Nice adjustment from Zhu Ting.
That has been one of the few times we've seen her not go to her full power.
Well, she adjusted in that last set. That was quite high for her. And knowing that, seeing the attackers, or the defenders rather, especially Shinabe, trying to go or trying to defend a long ball, she goes for the soft tip.
Once again, you know, you and I were talking about that. They're not really coming up with a varied attack. They've just been coming up with strong hits, strong hits, strong hits. It's Japan. That's why they probably got the third set.
Yeah.
They've come up with the adjustments.
Well, if VakifBank could variate their attacks as well, then maybe it could be an easier set for them again.
Hisamitsu still up by one. Another great serve by Nagaoka. And Zhu Ting says, let's go right back to my bread and butter.
Well, it's going to be easy for Zhu Ting. The one who went for the block was Nakaoji, single block.
We're tied at four. This is set number four. The first two sets, a dominating performance put together by the ladies from Istanbul. And then suddenly the Japanese made the adjustments. But here, back to our script in the first two sets, the height being might for Zhu Ting. Naz serving. Kashka got denied there. Slotches, that stays in.
Yep. Everybody was compressed in the middle of the court.
Naz with a serve again. From the back row. Nagaoka has been exceptional here today.
He has, and from all positions. And it's nice that, you know, no one was expecting it.
Naz back set goes to Zhu Ting again, and just what the doctor ordered.
You know, the good thing about Zhu Ting, it's really impressive, is that before that last attack coming from her, she was actually late for the block. And so when she makes a mistake, she makes up for it right away.
Zhu Ting with the serve. Nice floater. Quick play doesn't work for Tokarska. They go to the outside. Kimberly was dug. They go back to Kimberly. She goes down the line with success.
You know, the thing about Kimberly, and when she's that area, part of the court, She only has one blocker, and it's Nakaoji, a much shorter player compared to her. So you can't just expect her to go cross-court because she has a blocker. If she can go over the blocker, then there's an option to go down the line.
Tsui has done her job here today. So has Kazem. Look at the floor defense of the Japanese.
Nice.
What have we been talking about? They've hardly gone to that kind of a strategy when it comes to the attack.
And that's why right now the Japanese are, there was hesitation. Obviously, they could go after that ball if they wanted to, but three players hesitated for that save. And Gooka once again coming from the back line, hitting it hard, getting that point.
Look at how frustrated Suting is. That's why she is where she's at this particular stage in her career. They're up 2-1, and she's so disappointed in herself. Ishii, that's not going to go over. The lead is back up to 4 here for VakifBank. I think VakifBank says, I don't want to stay close with the Japanese because the last time it was close, we lost the set.
Yeah, I mean, if you could win it convincingly, you should.
Ishii gets denied again. They go back to her. What an adjustment she had to make coming from almost the outside. Timeout is going to come here for the Japanese. They need to talk things over. This lead is suddenly ballooned to 5. And the 6 is our tally. Istanbul up against Japan here in the 4th. Up 2-1. Excellent attack once again from Nagaoka.
Well, again, I mean, we have to say this. We've been saying it over and over again, but that's been the strategy that Japan has been going to, just trying to use the blockers to get that point.
Japan picks up another point. And the lead has been cut down to 3. Kimberly will deliver a point. Will stop the rally of the Japanese in their tracks. Serve from Slotches. That's long. She's had more than a few of her mistakes on serve. The lead, though, is still at 3. Ishii, good serve going down the line.
Great adjustment, but unfortunately, it goes out.
They've been trying to go to Akman a little bit more than they did in the first 2 sets, huh?
Well, she has been quiet.
They go back to the outside, Kimberly. That's 4 touches. Now suddenly here, the 4th, they're not attacking with all the power that we were so used to seeing them do in the first 2 sets.
Well, I think it's because they saw that it has been working, especially in the start of this fourth set, that, you know, the Japanese were actually all the way at the back of the court, really waiting for that long ball. And so they go short.
Back set. Nakoji. There it is once again. That excellent floor defense. To Tsui again. Going cross court. Will they ask for a challenge?
Looks like they're not, but the Japanese player for, you know, signaling there was a touch.
Well, the coach was all over that, so she was right close to the net. I guess she figured, let's not waste a challenge.
Nice set. Oh, but better block coming from Zhu Ting.
One and one, Zhu Ting Nagaoka. That's a great matchup. Is our tally. VakifBank now in control.
Go out again.
Wow. Looking back at their performance serving wise, that's exactly what they did in the first set.
Set. Yeah.
Uriya comes in. There's Tokarska on your screens. She has been leading the block for the Japanese squad. Zhu Ting just sends it over. Should not be denied. To the middle, Kimberly.
Great attack once again from VakifBank. Naz having that presence of mind, giving it to the backliner, knowing that, you know, her frontliners was, they were kind of scrambling for it. Two Japanese defenders just not ready for it.
Seemingly in complete control of the fourth set are the ladies from VakifBank. Combination play snuffed out. Here's Zhu.
Goes in.
The trajectory of that one was just lethal. Coach Giovanni there with a smile as he looks over to Zhu. You're doing good. You're doing good. Nagaoka. Doug. Zhu just sends it over. Shinabe goes down the line.
Shinabe, smart move once again, you know, knowing what she's up against. Two tall players right in front of you, you shouldn't force going cross court. If there's an opening down the line, then that's where you need to get the ball to.
Koto in. The Japanese down by five. They need to make some headway or else they're going to pick up their first loss of this tournament. To let everybody know, we are using the tablet system for substitutions now. So the coaches are given a tablet, and obviously the table officials also have the tablet of their own, and they just push the buttons, they send the signal saying, I want player so-and-so to come in, and that's what happens. So number one, Nagaoka will take a break first. She is also their captain.
Good block, but goes out.
The lead is now at six for VakifBank Istanbul. Not a good reception. Again, just too big.
Speaking of too big, Zhu Ting was too big for that attack.
Well, she was big in Rio, and she's showing us her strength here in Manila, Philippines. Timeout will be called by Coach Nakada. Second timeout for Hisamitsu here in the fourth. take a look at some of the reactions here from all the players that we have. So much emotions already being shown,
yes.
Denise. And this is only our first match of the tournament.
Well, we have to remember, this is such a short competition. So I could understand why they're so emotional at this early stage.
You know, I've had a chance to talk to a lot of these players in the past week, and a lot of them are just saying they feel so privileged to be able to be here in Manila and playing in this World Championships,
yeah.
Because they say it's not every day you play against world-class competition.
Exactly. You know, that's what I was saying a while ago. Just that experience that you gain from playing internationally will be a big benefit, not just for you, but for your whole team, and even for the level of sports of your country. So I understand why they feel that way.
Trying to get that through was Tokarska. She got denied. Tokarska's going to be seeing that block in her nightmares tonight. Zhu Ting with the serve. She goes high hands. But still, it's a 6-point deficit. They need to be able to overcome. Tokarska now with a serve. Slotches, Doug.
Nice.
In the middle. Chance once again. Where did they go? To Zhu Ting from the back. What a weapon.
And when you look at her, I personally find it funny, for the lack of a better term, that she's still not satisfied with her performance today.
As we said, that's what makes world champions. You push yourself,
yes,
to the limit. The lead is up to 7. That's going to go out.
Good call by Shinabe, letting it go.
Nagaoka comes right back in. They need her firepower together with Nakaoji, their starting setter. Set. Slotches. You know, Denise, I continue to marvel at the adjustments the Japanese,
yeah,
have made in that floor defense.
They have. They have been keeping that ball alive longer than they did in the first 2 sets.
And would you say, because of that, the other side now seems a little bit shell-shocked that all of a sudden, all our attacks, which looked like they were so easy in the first 2 sets, everything now is coming back.
Well, yeah, I wouldn't say that they're shocked, but I think they're not really expecting it as much. Like what you said, this player a while ago was at Akman, and she said that when she goes up, or Lonecki, but when she goes up, she's like, she thinks it's going to be a point, so somewhat she turns her back.
And she stops.
And she stops, expecting it to be a point for her team.
And all of a sudden, the ball is coming right back,
back,
and
yeah,
she's got to get back into position
exactly
for the attack. 22-16 is our tally. Kimberly has also been silenced here.
Mm-hmm.
22-17. Kazem shaking her head. The back row again, Zhu. Going cross court is Kimberly Hill.
Well, you were asking for her. Here she is.
Because, you know, in the first 2 sets, it was like a 3-pronged attack. You had Slotches, you had Hill, and you had Zhu Ting. But seemingly, you have her there on your screens, she's been thrust out of the situation, if you look at it. Back back set. Cross court works.
Yeah.
And there's Ackman. Ackman a little bit more active here in the third and fourth set. It's match point once again for Istanbul. This is match point number five. They had four in the third. That'll keep the Japanese alive just for the time being. Looking to end this match, Zhu Ting. That time, once again, not going with power,
yeah.
And it's proved to be effective.
Well, as we all know, with volleyball, it's not all about power, it's about smarts. And Zhu Ting just showing us how smart of a player she is and how quick or how high her volleyball IQ is.
It is a 3-set-to-1 victory here by VakifBank Istanbul. Flexing their muscles early, picking up the first two sets quite easily. They had a slight hiccup in the third as Hisamitsu Springs Kobe came up with a win in that extended third set. But order was restored in the fourth. Watch that last point. Hisamitsu Springs Kobe did their very best, but in the end, extreme firepower behind Zhu Ting, Kimberly Hill, and Loneki Schloches gives Istanbul this win. 25-14, 25-15, 29-31, and 25-18 is our final tally. Once again, just a reminder, this is only our first match. This is day number one of our six-day competition. We're coming to you live here from the SL Mall of Asia Arena as we take a look at the statistics. 3-1 victory by VakifBank Istanbul over Hisamitsu Springs, and only one ace for Hisamitsu in that last set. But the attacks, again, spelled the difference as expected. 17-12, errors just about even. And blocks, again, running true to form, going the way of VakifBank Istanbul. We'd like to remind everybody, join the conversation with hashtag FIVB Women's CWC. Send us your comments. We'd like to see whatever pictures you have of the players. They're going to be here for one whole week in Manila. World-class action coming your way right here from the Mall of Asia Arena. We do have 8 teams from all over the world landing here in Manila. You saw the first two, one from Istanbul and one from Japan. We have a team from the Philippines, from Switzerland, from Thailand, and from Italy and Brazil. The Philippines and Brazil will be playing in the main match later on today. Let's turn it over to Denise.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're here at the Mall of Asia Arena for the Women's Club World Championship, and VakifBank just defeated Hisamitsu in 4 sets. So Lonnie, you are our best player of the game. What can you say about the game so far, or what happened?
I think we did a good job in serving and like attack. I think that was our strong point, and overall we played a pretty good match, but I think we could still do better, so we want to show more nice volleyball and even better volleyball than we did today.
You know, it was a very convincing first and second set. It was a 10-point deficit, and it really looked like you were in control of the whole match. But come third, you guys lost it, 31-29. What do you think happened there?
I think the Japanese team did a really good job. They put a lot of pressure in serve, and also they found a way to avoid our block, like block out, block touch. They did a good job in that. And yeah, we had to find a solution for that. And I think in the fourth set, we managed.
Well, I think you did find the solution. Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, again, Lonnie Schloches.
Well, there you can see Lunecki Slotches very happy with her performance. Obviously, they had a little hiccup there. As we take a look at the match statistics, 3-1 victory here for VakifBank Istanbul. Total of 6 aces as compared to 4. The attacks, as expected, 12 more attacks here for VakifBank Istanbul. The errors, a whole lot for VakifBank. So that is what they need to be able to really look after, because 24 errors in a match as compared to 9 over Hisamitsu has got to be something that they need to correct. The blocks, totally dominating, was VakifBank, 27-5. Let's take a look at some of the highlights here of our match. It is a thrilling four-setter. And we're going to see, obviously, Lunecki, the girl you interviewed just a while ago, in some of the highlights we're going to be showing everybody now. There's Kimberly Hill, who started off strongly and finished off strongly as well. Smiles all around for VakifBank, and why not? They pick up win number one
here. Yeah, and again, we go back to that first and second set. It was a convincing win. Had a little trouble in the third set, but able to get back on their feet, get back on track, and win the game or the match in 4 sets.
And this is our standings. Actually, just after our first match, VakifBank quickly propels themselves on top. And Hisamitsu falls to the bottom, of course, with their first loss. Bangkok Glass and Valero Zurich will be able to be seen in action also later on today. But that does it here for our very first match. On behalf of my partner, Denise Tan, this is Anthony Sutai saying thanks for joining us, everybody. Till next time, take care. God bless.